George Conway, the husband of top Trump aide Kellyanne Conway, is once again taking shots at the president's mental health. This morning on Twitter, Conway tweeted this about his wife's boss. "You're not presidential at all, period. You're mentally unwell. You engage in bizarre, irrational, self-defeating behavior, which prompts criticism of you, which triggers more bizarre, irrational, self-defeating behavior. You would have been fired from any other job by now." Brian Stelter, the host of CNN's Reliable Sources, joins me now. Brian, Conway, obviously very, very vocal on Twitter, has been for a long time. You and he had a back and forth recently on Twitter. Take us through that exchange and your reaction.
Yeah, he's out there today, as he has in the past, but he continues to raise the volume on his comments about his wife's employer. So Conway today saying that the president is psychologically unfit, he should resign and seek treatment. I said, this is astonishing to see the husband of a top White House official say this on Twitter. Here's what Conway wrote back to me. He said, what is astonishing is the media's and the nation's utter failure to confront the fact that we have a psychologically and unwell and unfit president. That's the latest comment from George Conway. Look, he has avoided saying these kinds of things on television or at public events. Instead, he has chosen Twitter as his forum, as his medium. There are some people out there that think that George and Kellyanne Conway, it's like some sort of staged wrestling act. Give me a break. This is a high-ranking Republican lawyer, decades of experience, who's been calling out Trump while his wife works in the Trump White House. It's a very strange situation, but in some ways, it's just a really heightened, extreme version of what's happened in a lot of families across the country, families that have lots of disagreements about the president. Obviously, the difference in this case, Alex, is it's the husband of a top White House aide saying the president's mentally unwell and needs to resign.
Yeah, whether fabricated or not, it's an extraordinary dynamic to watch play out. But Brian, it's not just people who are outside the administration like George Conway is who are saying this. You earlier on your show had CNN's chief White House correspondent, Jim Acosta, this morning. He's out with a new book. It's called Enemy of the People. And in that book, he quotes an unnamed senior White House official who said, quote, "The president is insane." Here's his response to whether that person was being literal or not.
Yeah.
I think he was venting his frustrations, this particular official. We sat down one afternoon to talk about how things were going with this particular source's area of expertise. I don't want to get too deeply into that, but plopped down in the seat in front of me and said, "The president's insane." And I later went back and talked to this official and said, "Well, why did you say that?" And this official said, "You know, really, I was just frustrated with the president's lack of understanding about the Constitution, the constraints placed on the presidency, you know, guardrails that were put in place by our founding fathers."
So, Brian, in listening to Jim, what do you think? Literal or not?
Right. Jim was saying, you know, it's the idea of crazy versus crazy like a fox. And Acosta usually comes down on the side of crazy like a fox, that's what's going on when we see erratic behavior and other conduct from President Trump. But clearly, there is this incredible, you know, dissent that sometimes occurs among White House aides, among former aides, and again, even people that are in that inner circle, in that orbit, like George Conway, who is married to one of the president's top advisors. It is not normal for us to be talking about whether the president has a mental stability issue. And yet, that's been going on now for quite a while, hasn't it? It is notable that Conway continues to raise his voice about this issue.